Hey there, friends on YouTube. My name is Jason, sometimes known as the JTL. This is Painfully Honest Tech, Painfully Honest Tech. And today we've got the iPhone 15 Pro Max in the natural titanium. So I didn't think I was gonna be able to get one of these. On pre-order day, the Apple Store app, which is not to be confused with the Apple App Store, Apple Store app, was all messed up, and I didn't get in until everything was like 2.5, 3, 4 weeks out. So I couldn't order one and get it by launch day. Usually I go and get one from my carrier store. I live in Iowa, okay? It's not like other places where when you go to the Apple Store, of which there is only one in this state and it's 2.5 hours away. You know, you go and you look on Twitter or wherever and you see there's all these people out there. They're doing their waiting in line at the Apple Store, and Tim Cook is in New York on Fifth Avenue coming out of the store and greeting people and shaking hands like he's the Pope. In Iowa, the Verizon store opens at 9 a.m. and there's no line and no people, and you walk in and have your choice of just smiling-faced Verizon employees waiting to get you your phone. Now, I woke up early this morning, because I always get a little anxious on iPhone day. I woke up a little early this morning, like 5 a.m. instead of 7 a.m., and I don't think I was really sleeping all that well to begin with. I woke up early, and I went online to see what they had in stock, because now Verizon will tell you, like, what's in... Wait, this is kind of crooked, isn't it? There. Verizon will now tell you, that, like, you can see what's available in your local store, and they had no Pro Max is listed. But here's a piece of advice for you. If you're gonna go to your carrier store on launch day and get yourself an iPhone, don't pre-order it. Don't go by what it says on the website, no matter how close to the time the store is opening is. Don't do that, because I just walked in and said, he said, well, what do you want? And I said, well, I would prefer the Pro Max. And he said, what color? And I said, titanium. And he said, they're all titanium. And I said, natural titanium then. And they went back and they got me one. 256 gigabytes. Gigabytes! And now I'm gonna open it and I'm gonna look at it, and over the next few weeks I'm gonna talk about it. I've got my iPhone 12 Pro Max here as well, so we can test the 12 Pro Max against the iPhone 15 Pro Max and see if there's anything obviously improved. I'm not sure that, well, of course there will be, but you know, this is $1,200. This was $1,100 4 years ago. You know what I'm talking about. We're peeling. And this, like, I miss the cellophane. I'm sorry if it's not good for the environment. I miss the cellophane. Ooh. Now see, look here. This makes it look like this looks kind of gold. Even though they don't have a color this year, this looks kind of gold. All the pictures look kind of gold. This does not look gold. This, yeah. I'm glad that I went for this color, because it is a pretty nice. Pretty nice color. Okay, so we'll just peel. This is all you get. Immediately, I notice a little bit more roundedness in the screen, which is nice, and a little bit less of a sharp edge here on the, if you see here, rounded edge, sharp edge. I like the sharp edge. It didn't bother me the way it bothered some other people, but here we have it. And I will say this. If you'll look at my 12 Pro Max, it is still pristine. Like, there's maybe a couple of scratches on the front here, but not really anything that I can see. And I used it 90% of the time without a case for 3.5 years or whatever it was. So that really, I mean, I used the Pixel Fold and the Z Fold 5 for 2 weeks, and they each got micro scratches on the top. Never put a screen protector on this thing. Never did anything. So, 12 Pro Max, still a very good phone. Whether or not this is a good upgrade, I should say, remains to be seen. So the camera thingies, wow, they call them lenses. The lenses are definitely larger on this one. This one has the telescopic, photographic, periscopic lens that has five times zoom in it. Here's your braided USB-C to USB-C cable. Honestly, like, USB-C is not that exciting to me. I'm glad it's USB-C, because I don't have to worry about finding, actually, I always could not find my lightning cables because I have so many USB-C cables, but it's a nice cable. It's braided. I'm sure it'll get dirty and look like it just got dragged through poop. pretty soon, but right now, it's a nice looking cable, but it's very short. This is like 1 meter cable, 1 meter. It's a jump rope. Anyway, I likely won't use this because I always use MagSafe. What else is in the box, ladies and gentlemen? Well, nada. We've got, you no longer need a physical SIM card, which still makes me mad, but I guess I have to accept it that that's the way life is. And you got that, and then you got a white Apple sticker. Don't care about that either, so get out of my way. Inside of the box, I'm more excited. Am I more excited about this phone? I'm excited about this phone, okay? Don't get me wrong. I'm glad that it is, that it's got some more camera lens stuff going on. I'm anxious to sort of check out the action button. I've been using iOS 17 on the 12 Pro Max, and but I haven't really dug into it very much. I figured I'd wait for the final version to be out, and then I'd dig into it. Now, maybe I'll do a favorite features of iOS 17 when the time comes. Let me know if you want to see that down in the comments. It says it's 7:25 in the morning. It's not 7:25 in the morning. It's 10 something, but I suppose I have to start it up. Appearance, medium, large. My wife uses large. I can't even read her phone. I got bad eyesight for sure. I'm gonna go with default though. Quick start. No, do I wanna do that? Yeah, I guess so. Sign into my Wi-Fi. Don't look. Here we go. I misspelled it. Okay, it may take a few minutes to activate. While it's doing that, let's take another look around. I hope that this comes through well on the camera because this titanium color is, it's not so, I mean, they called the white silver for a long time, and there is a white color that I think they're still calling silver titanium, but this is what I would call silver, and I like it. It's muted, but it's not dark. I usually go for the darker phones, and this is a nice combination of sort of a lighter color, but not so bright, and the rails are rounded. Let's take a look at the size of these two things together. They look relatively the same, but it is more rounded on the edges than the 12 Pro Max, and that's nice. Look at the sides. So, no SIM card tray, just one power button on this side. Bring this up. Volume buttons, no more mute switch, just this button. And no more of that SIM card tray. Check out the bottom. I mean, physically, the bottom doesn't look really all that different. It's just USB-C here. It's a little wider port than that. And the nice thing about this is the Pro Max models have USB-C 3, which gives you 10 gigabits per second of download or upload speed from the cable. That's nice. I'll test that in a later video as I get more deeply into it. The sides are more rounded. I do like the fact that we have no shiny stuff on here. So you've got shiny rails on this, which always collected tons and tons of fingerprints. And then this is a matte color, which I prefer. Like, imagine an iPhone where the back and the sides don't get fingerprinty. That's just awesome. Of course, we've got the dynamic island here and all the other stuff you expect to see. We have the antenna bands. These are gigantic. These lenses are gigantic. I mean, every year I think that the lenses are going to get more gigantic. How much more gigantic could they be? But they are. We can look at the bezels here too. A nice comparison here. If you see the bezels on the 12 Pro Max are a good 1/3 of an inch, I guess? I don't know. I don't have a tape measure here. And these are just very, very slim. So they did get the bezels almost to the very, very edge here. I'm still not a huge fan of the dynamic island, honestly. I know that it does cool things, but the notch at least, like, could hide itself away. The dynamic island is here. It's got screen in between both of the top and the bottom. I had the 14 Pro Max last year, and I let my wife have it because I wanted to still be able to carry a SIM card, and couldn't do that in this because I switch my phones every year, like, you know, a bunch of different times, like to all the different Android phones and all that kind of stuff. So having eSIM only was not the best thing for me, but that's the way it was. eSIM was the way to go, I guess. Maybe it's good for the environment. We'll have to ask Mother Nature the next time Octavia Spencer blows in. I got her name wrong in my last video about the iPhone. I said Octavia Butler, who obviously is a writer of novels. I do have a master's degree in fiction writing, so maybe it's an honest mistake on my part. That's the Octavia that is in my head more often, I guess, maybe. Octavia Spencer, though, take nothing away, very good actress, although her Apple series was not very good. And I thought it was going to be great because I love true crime podcasts. And so I thought an Apple TV show about a true crime podcast that actually solves crimes, that's going to be awesome. I don't know why I thought that, because while it sounds like a cool premise, how could it really be cool? What else can I say about this? The weight. Oh, yes. The weight of this thing is, I don't know if it was going to be noticeably lighter, but it is noticeably lighter, which is nice. And it, because it's curved, it almost seems smaller. It fits well in the hand, ladies. It's a very good phone. So I'm going to put it through its paces and get back to you with like a 72-hour review. So stay tuned for that. Get subscribed if you're not already subscribed, so that I can get myself going with this guy and really compare and contrast. I do want to know what I'm gaining from the 12 Pro Max. It should be something besides just the physical features that I'm gaining. So I'll let you know if you have questions, things that you want to know about the iPhone 15 Pro Max. Do let me know down in the comments below, and I'll be sure to highlight your questions in that next video. If you want to check out the merch that's available down below, there's some Painfully Honest Tech merch. Hit my Linktree link to go to see all of the Amazon related stuff. I have t-shirts that I've made. I have written a book. I have written several albums worth of music. They are all available on Amazon. In fact, all of my music is available on any streaming platform. However, you can also go to bandcamp.com/StarCity or /Sad Iron Music and get, you know, actually support the channel by purchasing that music. You can listen to it on any streaming service, though. Star City and Sad Iron Music and Jason T. Lewis. You look up Jason T. Lewis, you'll find probably all of it. Anyway, thanks so much for being here. My name is Jason, sometimes known as the JTL. This is Painfully Honest Tech, iPhone 15 Pro Max, titanium. Until the next time, I'm out.